dignitaries, and the dais of the dais. My affectionate friend, the speaker, beloved husband of Dr. Nalina Donat, Robert Donat, family members of Dr. Nalina Donat, participants of this most important memorial service are gathered here. Respected invitees, today we have assembled here to pay our rich tributes to the departed soul, Dr. Nalina Donat. Just now, our sister read to us the life sketch of Dr. Nalina Donat. She has traveled in our life nearly about 64 years. About 31 years back, I met her along with Dr. Robert Donat in their house at Vasant Nagar. I went to that house as a lawyer to counsel the family. They were undergoing great ordeal during that period. I don't want to mention the details of my dream and what I counseled her at this stage. Life is a so journey. We are in this universe. We are in a complex society, in a multi-religion country. There are certain wrong misconceptions, wrong notions about life. That is because lack of proper understanding of the humanity, the universe, and living creatures. We have assembled here to remember Dr. Nalina Donat. She was a daughter. She is a daughter of a bureaucrat married to a doctor, Robert Donat. According to me, Robert Donat belongs to intellectual class. He has undergone lot of ordeal over a period of 3 decades in his career. During that time, he met me. My relationship with him as a lawyer and a client, way back in 1986. I am only giving brief note about this because how people across the religion, irrespective of the religion, in a society, where the people treat the humanity, which is a great lesson for others to remember. The pain and suffering of gone on for 3 decades reflected very badly on the family members of Robert Donald. I wanted to only mention that a memorial service like this, we have to understand the human being and society in which we will be living, and how a human being must live, how one human being must treat other human being irrespective of their economic status and intellectual status. We must pay rich tributes to Dr. Nalina Donald. Despite the obstacles in the life, so journey, she concentrated in her profession of teaching. She aimed to get distinction in the society, that she must write a thesis and get doctorate. The great quality of Dr. Nalina Donald, not only she is highly educated, qualified lady, achieved the doctorateship, given care, love and affection to the children, and she has discharged her marital life with her beloved husband, Dr. Robert Donald. So these are the lessons the young generation of womanhood must take brief note of Dr. Nalina Donald, and proceed further in the rest of your life to pay our rich tributes and pay our respects to Dr. Nalina Donald. I told you, we are living in a conflict society, multi-religious society, country, population 129 crores. I also mentioned the living creatures. In the universe, not only the rational human being, the living creatures also have got right under the constitution and the statutory rights. So, we forget everything when we are in a society, the reflection of the societal character will be reflecting on the human beings irrespective of the religion. We believe the whole, more than 2/3 of the population of the world is, we believe Yesu was crucified. We also believe that Yesu is not dead, he is alive. That's what he read to us. We believe in Christianity, human beings will not die. Human beings will be sleeping. They may not have the physical structure of the body, but their deeds and thoughts will be simmering in the nature. This is a great lesson for us. I am only mentioning why 2/3 population of the world believe, pray every Friday, every Sunday, early morning, very methodically, systematically, in every church, the prayers are conducted. So we believe in an ideology of the Yesu. It is the Christian community, according to me, who are great people, render service to the have-nots of the universe. And you are the people who love the mankind. So what a great quality which you have imbibed. You are an extraordinary human being. In that group, I think Dr. Donald and Melina Donald joined. That's why on a Sunday, 11th day of her demise, we are assembled here and we are conducting memorial service, remembering her as the eighth child of their parents. Great responsibility she had taken. She got educated. She rendered service to the students community. Not only that, she has rendered service to the community as law at large. Service to the family members. I don't want to stand before you because number of other learned speakers are going to address you. I am on my behalf, on behalf of the entire humanity, I pray the nature and Yesu, Nalina Donald is not physically before us. She is surrounding us in the nature, in the air, in the water, in the everywhere. Sarvantriyam. I only pray in this memorial service, let our soul rest in peace. I only appeal to the daughter and the son and daughter-in-law, the son-in-law, and Dr. Donald, Robert Donald, to follow and finish her unfinished deeds she has left out. I appeal to the members, family members of Dr. Nalina Donald, please take care of your father. You are the mother, you are everything. And the Dr. Donald has to leave alone to protect the humanity by using his intellectual acumen. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ನಾನು ವಂದಿಸಿ ನಾನು ಈ ಸ್ಮರಣಾರ್ಥದ ಸೇವೆ ಸಭೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರಾಬರ್ಟ್ ಡೊನಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ವಂದಿಸಿ ಇಡೀ ಮಾನವ ಕುಟುಂಬಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಾಗಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನಳಿನಾ ಡೊನಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಆತ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಶಾಂತಿ ಸಿಗಲಿ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನನ್ನ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ವಂದಿಸಿ.
Sunrise, you know. Though the sun goes down, that's your business.